Hello, it's Christian Boogie here, and welcome back to another video. Today, we're going to be doing a series called 5-Year Plan for 2017 to 2021. So in this series, I will be running down a few parks in America or any other countries or whatever to see what future attractions may look. But here's the thing, none of this is confirmed. This is all speculation. Finding out what Cedar Point will be adding for what things that they can add. So, as an honor, why don't we start at the roller coaster capital of the world, Cedar Point, my number one favorite amusement park. Number one, the hot center of the planet. So, today, let's go back to the last 5 years of Cedar Point and see what Cedar Point had in the last 5 years. They had a good last 5 years. So in 2011, they added their Wind Seeker spinning ride that goes up in the air 301 feet. They added an animatronic. In 2012, they added an animatronic dinosaur thing called Dinosaur Drive right next to the Millennium Force roller coaster. In 2013, they remodeled the entrance to make the Gatekeeper roller coaster, and then they took out Disaster Transport and the Space Barber. In 2014, they added the Gemini expansion with Pipe Spring and Lake Baby Eagles. And in 2015, they repainted and remodeled Mantis and become Rubaroo, the floorless coaster. And finally, in 2016, they just added their B&M dive coaster, Valerie. Okay, so let's get this going. In 2017, I predict that they would have a B&M hybrid coaster, a B&M that goes over 200 feet, and what they do, and what they should do with it is that they should put it in the spot right near where Challenge Park was. They should put it right in the spot where Ripcord was, since they were relocated. And instead of like going it under like the track of Magnum, they should just like dig a hole for the top, an iron tunnel, and then after the drop, it should go through. Like I said, you can always put a coaster. They can always put a coaster in the Challenge Park, because besides, I don't know. Like I said before, none of this is confirmed. This is all speculation. I predict that they would put a roller coaster. People say, oh, Cedar Point doesn't really need another hyper coaster. Besides, they just got Val Raven. Val Raven just goes over 223 feet. And then, something with what happens if they put a 240 foot roller coaster? They never add one of those. And like I said before, you can put a roller coaster in the Child's Park. Those good work, waters are there or anything. But this is all speculation. In 2018, I predict that they will focus on the family rides. Cedar Point has a great lineup of family rides. And what they should do is they are really good with family rides. They know, like, say they add like an SNS flat ride or something, they could put it like somewhere like, they probably put it like somewhere like in like the middle of the park, like somewhere like around near the Raptor. If they did, that would be a great thing for the park. In 2019, I predict that they would have a B&M flying coaster that goes over Lake Erie, or probably make a tunnel and probably goes over Lake Erie, probably swoops over Lake Erie, and that would be pretty cool and stuff. I would like to see a flying coaster at Cedar Point, because Cedar Point has a great lineup of B&Ms. If they did do that for the 2019 season, that would be pretty cool. And yeah. In 2020, it will be the Cedar Point Park 150th anniversary, which is going to be a hit. And what they're going to do is they're going to strip the track of Main Street and make it an offer to RMC. And a lot of speculation is going on saying they're going to RMC Main Street. I kind of believe that. My dad doesn't believe that since Main Street is one of his favorites roller coasters. And that would be a great fit that they would add like a peanut. Like, why not a kid say peanut? Like an RMC. They should call it RMC Main Street. And that would be really cool because to the point, could that Taco Truck or Primal's Truck, you may never know. In 2021, I predict that they would expand Soak City. Like, they would expansion, like, add, like, a dive water slide or something. Like, the ones they have, like, at Six Flags Water Parks. Like, say you put yourself in, like, a tube, and then you whip, like, I don't know, probably, like, 3 seconds, and you're just, like, boom. You, like, drop down, like, the thing that, like, drops you down, like, you don't even know what's happening. It feels like, whoa! And then you hold your hand, and then you go like this, like when you do a more strong slice. So that's basically my 5-year plan. And that's the 5-year plan that we are looking forward to. Probably people would say that they would add a truck at Dark Ride for 2017 season. And probably people say that they would add a B&M flying coaster in, probably in 2021. That would be a great thing for the park. So yeah, guys, that's my rundown of the 2017 to 2021 season attractions to your point. So guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. If you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below. Peace out.